Hello, everyone. It's Saturday night. You know what that means? It's Connect Now. And what topics we got to talk about? Let's talk about Trey Song. Yes, Trey Song has a alleged sex tape. We'll get to the bottom of it, what Brittany Shea thinks about it. And what is Trey Song? If that's his new career after music, we'll get to that. Plus, Wendy Williams, she had her biopic last week. We're great reviews on her biopic. We'll get to the. We'll talk about that, about her biopic, and is she hiding something else that she doesn't want to talk about? We'll get to that. And Super Sunday, the Super Bowl, the Kansas City Chiefs takes on the Tampa Bay Bucks in the Super Bowl this tomorrow night. Super Bowl weekend, could Tom Brady clinch his 10th appearance and win another Super Bowl ring? We'll get to all this and more as Connect Now starts after the countdown. Welcome on this Super Bowl Eve edition of Connect Now for Saturday, February the 6th, 2021. I'm your host, as always, Kendra Dix, alongside my co-host, Brittany Shea. Brittany Shea, hey. How you doing on this super Sunday Eve Super Bowl?
I'm doing good.
All right. Before we jump in the conversation, join the conversation by using the hashtag Connect Now here on Connect TV. And don't forget to subscribe. Subscribers can. Tell a friend, call a friend, hit that subscribe button so you won't miss a thing here on Connect Now. All right, Brittany, we got a lot of topics to get ahead to. Let's get started with the Trey Song has a alleged sex tape and the public goes bananas.
Yeah, they did. Especially on Twitter. So Trey Song's recently started OnlyFans. Mm-hmm. And I'm not for sure if he leaked it or someone leaked it, but basically there's a video of him in his, you know, penis and some lady, you know, giving fellatio to it. And a lot of people on Twitter were reacting and, you know, mostly women here, probably some gays too, you know, going Google Gaga. going Google Gaga for it. But a question has been raised, like, you know, because Trey Song has alleged, you know, sexual allegations against him. So mm-hmm. A lot of people don't know how to feel about it. Like, a lot of people are here for it. A lot of people are like, hold on now. I don't think we should be that here for it. Because, you know, Keke Palmer and other women, Celine Powell, other women had coming out saying things about Trey Song. So, it's everybody on the fence about it. It's like, people like it, but they still like, ooh, I don't know if I should like it. I don't know if I should or should I like it.
Mm. Well, it is what it is. Trey Song's celebrity, so him being a celebrity, he gets the perks.
So I mean, it is what it is. It's out there. So
it's out there for the whole world to see. So
right.
All right. Speaking of that, Megan Thee Stallion and CardiB released their respective videos. Cry Baby from Megan with the baby and CardiB with Up. What you thought about the song?
I thought the song was good. I mean, it's okay. It sounded like a typical CardiB song to me. You know what I'm saying? So yeah. That's what I thought. She doing what she can to make money and sell records. So,
did you still think she need to have an album? They said she got like 20, 50 songs already in line. She said she's gonna drop an album sometime this in the end of the year or something.
Yeah, I mean, she might well go and drop an album because the people waiting on the sophomore album. I think, you know, with that sophomore album, it's very telling whether, you know, you're going to be a hit or a miss coming in the future. So, what you think?
Like I said about Cardi B, she, you know, sex sells. Sex gonna sell anything going on. Typical Cardi B. So Cardi B just making money. And then did you hear about the Super Bowl commercial she doing with Wayne's World?
Yeah, I saw that.
I said, what the fuck? What the hell that? But you know, it's just that, you know, money sells. So if it works for Cardi B, it works for her. So you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. She gonna do what she can to make her hit and make money.
What you thought about the Megan Thee Stallion video?
I mean, I thought it was okay. Cry Baby, I like that song too. So I feel like, you know, they doing what the rap girls doing now. They singing, dancing. They either talking about sex, money, or
Rock and
clothes,
roll.
or drugs, or whatever the fuck they talking about.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah,
So.
she. But I like the beat to him. Bah, bah, bah.
Yeah, I like that
You
too.
know? Yeah, the beat. Can't get
But
the
you
beat
know,
out your head. Go ahead, bro.
excuse me. You know what? I was gonna say, like, one thing, I'm gonna have to say this. Like, Nicki Minaj, plain and simple, she gonna always be the queen. And I ain't even a barb like that. But it's like the girls now, the lyricism, and I seen a lot of that too, complain about the lyricism. They don't have no lyricism too much. They always talk about the same thing over and over again. Or it's the same beat over and over again. Or it's twerk music. That's all it is.
You
There's
know what?
no nothing new. It's like the wheel. You know what I'm saying? Like they keep trying to reinvent the wheel, but you can't. I mean, the wheel is the wheel. Like y'all doing the same thing over and over again. But do you go off?
Well, we'll see on that. Also, Wendy Williams, well, we're gonna get into it. Wendy Williams, she her biopic gets good reviews on Lifetime. And she continues her quest for love. What you thought about the Wendy Williams biopic?
It was, I feel like at first, the first hour was focused on her and the last hour was focused on Kevin.
You think she's still in love with that man?
Yeah, I mean, the way she was crying and carrying on, I said, damn, yeah, she got to be. She like, she heartbroken still.
She was like, oh. She said that bitch arena ruined everything. But I think she kind of led to it. She was enabling him doing that. Because she knew, why would you even, you know, a married woman like Wendy Williams, why would you enable another lady, a side chick, taking all your money and your husband giving her, his, your money to her, buying her rings, diamond rings, and black paint? I'm singing like Johnny Gill and stuff.
No. Diamond ring, black guy. How it going? Gasoline, made
Diamond ring, black guy, cars, money, 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 money.
it. But you know what? That's I gotta give it to Serena. Shit, the finesse a man for how long? 10, 15 years, and the woman taking care of you. Oh yeah, y'all both living eating off this woman money. Like, damn. She ain't got no type of shame. Now one of them.
No. But you kind of feel sorry for her, but then too, Wendy Williams is just that. You know, the deuce is right there. Deuces.
Yeah, Serena said, bitch, I'm living good, eating good off your money while you up there falling on TV and shit and falling on hard times.
Yeah, she could be following hard times. We just, you know, that's how
Yeah.
it be.
Yeah, but then again, that's a shame of them to be living off of someone else's hard work.
I think Wendy Williams kind of knew what she was getting herself into, and she just went along. I think it's just that New York mentality. Like, if you live in New York City, in Lango, you could be in a relationship, you know, in and out. You know how that go. So, speaking of that, Tom Brady and Patrick Mahomes face off for Super Bowl coming up tomorrow, and Tom Brady makes his 10th appearance as a Tampa Bay Buck. So, what you think about Tom Brady? Who you got?
Damn. Tom Brady. I'm gonna say Tom Brady.
Okay,
Who'd
since
you
he
say?
I say Patrick Mahomes, because they young. He young. He's got good offense and stuff. So you know how they go. So
yeah,
I'm gonna go with the Chiefs since they won it last year. They can do it again this year. So
yeah, they could.
So we're gonna go with that. But speaking of that, what do you think about the Super Bowl commercials?
It's gonna be interesting.
Ain't that's one that's out there with what's his name? Matthew McConaughey.
Yeah, he was like flat or something.
Yeah. I was like, what the? You know what? And then Michael B. Jordan got a commercial with the woman lusting over him and stuff.
Right.
And I think what that girl, Maya Rudolph, she got a commercial.
She got a commercial?
Yeah. Oh. She got a commercial. You see right here, she got four of her sales, like they the four horsewomen.
My God.
Yeah, well, that's just the one with the Matthew McConaughey, that kind of spooked me off. I was like, what?
Yeah, that girl? One was really weird.
I said they had to have him, you know what I'm saying? He took that money and he ran with it.
Yeah.
I said CGI. they can make me flat.
Well, that's CGI shit.
And then the Michael B. Jordan one looked like the woman lusting over him than her own husband.
Yeah. She was.
I'm like, wow. Well, we look forward to see the commercials. What about Jeff Bezos, the head of Amazon, decided this week that he's stepping down Amazon, but he will remain executive chairman. So what's your thoughts on Jeff Bezos stepping down Amazon after receiving criticism for years?
Maybe he just tired of the shit, I guess. I guess. I mean, he could be trying to be like, well, what do I want to say? I think he just like stepping down because he probably don't want no more responsibility of this shit no more.
I think he still want to be in the company, but he just don't want to run the day-to-day responsibility.
Right. That's what I'm saying. Like, he probably like, I'm over this shit.
Yeah. But what about this? NBA player LeBron James being confronted by a courtside Karen.
She'll sit her head down.
Like, LeBron was playing basketball until he told courtside Karen to put a mask on, and she simply refused.
And white privilege.
White privilege.
Mm-hmm. Of course, you don't tell me.
Yeah, that's what she was saying to LeBron too.
LeBron probably said, "Bitch, I said put a mask on."
And the power LeBron got, the NBA power, he had ejected both of them out.
Because if y'all want to sit up here and not wear no mask, y'all get the hell on. That's basically what he's saying.
Yeah, he did. And she wasn't having it, so you know how that shit go.
And so many words that LeBron said. He said, y'all get the fuck out of here.
Yeah. Also, Black Lives Matter and Stacey Abrams are both nominated for a Nobel Peace Prize. What's your thoughts on Black Lives Matter and Stacey Abrams being nominated for a Nobel Peace Prize?
I mean, it makes sense because that's the two things that were kind of monumental in 2021.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, Stacey Abrams, I believe both of them deserve it. To me, the ones that's trying to affect positive change in the Black Lives Matter. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, and they said Stacey Abrams was credited for doing that voter registration in Georgia that led to Biden getting the victory for president in the two senators.
Oh yeah.
So Stacey Abrams might win it.
Yeah, she need to be credited. Cause she put her work in for that. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, she did. She did. All right, speaking of that, what you thought about this girl made rounds on the weekend about putting Gorilla Glue on her head, and now she can't get the Gorilla Glue off her head. And she tried to get the Gorilla Glue company to see how could she get that glue off her head. What's your whole thing thoughts on just her just putting it out there? And why would she even put Gorilla Glue on her head in the first place?
Which according to her, she said, she basically said that she ran out of jail.
Well, go to the damn beauty supply store.
I know, but I can't tell you. It looked like, I don't know if she thought about, because it's like Gorilla Snot. It's so-called Gorilla Snot, which is gel, and then that Gorilla Glue. So I don't know what the fuck, I don't know how she got that mixed up, but when I saw that, her hair was hard than a motherfucking rock. You know what I'm saying? Hard than a helmet. Harder than the floor. Harder than concrete. When she put that motherfucking shampoo on that hair, and that bitch didn't move. It didn't move. I said, hell no, her hair is gone. Whenever whoever can help her get that out of her head, her hair is gone. She gonna have to start the fuck over.
She just had to be bald head again, yeah. Right?
That in one of them cases, well, guess what? I'm gonna have to start the fuck over. Yeah, I'm gonna have to be bald headed and put a wig on.
Why would the fuck would she even put Gorilla Glue on her head in the first place?
She said she ran out of jail. That's all I know. I don't know if she mistaken it for Gorilla Snot or what, but that's the worst. I feel like I pray for her, because that's the worst mistake she made in her fucking life.
Yeah.
Look at this right here with the conditioner. She did that. She rinsed that shit off her head. That shit did not move. And she said it was in her head like that for a month. You should have got a help the day after, not a month. The day after that shit happened. And like you said, Gorilla Glue was trying to tell her, hey, put rub alcohol, put this, did that. And speaking of her, can see right there, got to be glue. That's glue right there. Got to be glue. That's gel, kind of like a gel thing. It's adhesive, but it don't take your hair out. So that's a really good product. But the one in the middle, that's for like shit to fix around the house with wood and shit. You know what I'm saying? I feel bad for her. I feel bad for her. Yeah, I hope she got it fixed.
I don't think so, Brittany. She's still bitching and complaining about that this time. And she's scratching her head trying to get the shampoo and thinking that's going to work. That ain't going to work. But
we got to do an update on her to find out, did she get the help she need?
We have to. Shit. We going to. We got to. All right. Speaking of that, you know about this representative in Georgia named Marjorie Greene Taylor. Mm-hmm. Who's been causing the ruckus.
Mm-hmm.
She's been stripped of the House. So she can't make House decisions because the Democratic House made sure that, you know, she can't be in the education budget, the finance budget, you know, budgets that senators and lawmakers do. She can't do that. She just there for president.
Mm-hmm.
So she's been a Trump supporter and stuff, and she's been thinking about QAnon and the rest of them. So what's your thoughts on Marjorie Greene Taylor being shunned by a lot of the House?
Bye. Have a good day.
You see, she got the free speech, and then she's a Trump supporter.
Yeah. Bye, girl. We ain't got nothing for you.
No, nobody don't got nothing for her this time. Nobody got nothing for her this time.
Mm-mm, not a thing.
So we know tomorrow is Super Bowl weekend. We know that Jasmine Sullivan, Everett Church, The Weeknd, and Miley Cyrus, they all supposed to be doing performances at the Super Bowl.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think The Weeknd gonna blow it out during the Super Bowl?
Yeah, I think he gonna do something weird, but that's okay.
Weird is fun, right?
Mm-hmm. He gonna do some weird
shit.
But he got good music though. But sometimes his music, all he talk about is like some crazy shit. Like sometimes he be talking about drugs, and sound like he be talking about killing himself and killing. I don't know. It's just weird. But he, that like his, ooh, I'm blinded by the lights.
Yeah. I think sometimes with them, with him and stuff, he don't know. He kind of weird, but hey, it works for him, then it works for him.
Yeah.
All right. So we're going to end Connect Now this week. We hope to see you next week for another edition of Connect Now. For Brittany Shea, I've been your host, Kendra Dick, saying so long. We'll see you next week for another edition. Connect Now.